Cajun Def 11 on my fucking birthday all night we were out here.
Freezing fucking cold. And I remember thinking, hey, yo, listen, they said that we are not to come in there. Our job is to stand out here and not see what was going on. Following Monday,
yo, I don't like those young bulls who's at the gate, those new guys. They got a fucking attitude.
A fucking attitude?
We got an attitude for doing our job. The job you told us to do, we got an attitude for, right?
I made sure that before I fucking came here, I knew who everybody was. I watched everybody's matches. I studied fucking everybody to make sure there was no one who would feel disrespected because I didn't know who they were.
Now, see, that's where you're wrong, and that's where you messed up at. Granted, we didn't know back then, but that's where you messed up at. You sit up here, and you try to play the game, you try to be nice, you try to shake hands and all that other dumb shit. It don't get you nowhere.
Paying dues? Motherfuckers say you always paying dues. My debt, my medical bills tell me I fucking paid dues. I fucking dislocated my shoulder for the first time right in the arena. This is where everything started. This is supposedly our home. When you look up the definition of the word home, warmth, positivity, memory, there's no fucking positivity in that place at all. The only people that people give a fuck about is whatever white motherfucker who's the flavor of the month. Every single time a black person gets a shot, they become world heavyweight champion. And what happens? They get distracted for a little bit and then they go ghost. They go nowhere. They get to do nothing. In fact, the last black man who got the strap, he had it for a week and lost it to who?
Why is this shit happening? The fucking tag titles. They lost them in England to who? When the last time they was here? This the shit I'm talking about right here.
The icing on the cake. You bring in these two New York niggas. Gosh. Everybody was on their top.
Oh,
everybody. And then at the end of the match, as they sitting there dancing and proud of themselves.
Dancing, motherfucking Uncle Tom ass. They're busting a jig for the boss, man. And everybody there, all the fans. For what?
They extend their hands. Now, first off, let's look at that for a moment. They were the young guys coming in, and they extended the hands. It was supposed to be us. We were supposed to say, good job, young boy. You did all right. But no, they threw the hands up. And then the first thing that happened was the crowd. It wasn't private party, private party, private party. Dub boys, dub boys, dub boys. It was private party, private party, private party. But why?
Private.
What did they really do? They didn't do shit.
Oh my God, the month before, TLC, we're the fucking main event. We ain't even on the damn DVD cover. Have you lost your fucking minds? Hard work gets you nothing. Where's our respect? Where's the shit that we're owed? The shit that we fucking deserve. CZW can't get you that. CZW don't hand that out to you.
CZW, how long we have to deal with this?
So then you gotta take it.
This dub boy, young boy shit is over.
I meant it. This dub boy shit, this carrying a black and yellow on our backs, this carrying that tag team division, oh yeah, carrying it. Because everybody else will come and go. Everybody else will walk right in and they'll walk right out whenever they damn well please.
We're gonna get what's owed to us. Because, yo, I'm starting to learn. I get it. I get it. Hard work and dedication is for fools. Straight up fools. It's about your rep. That's the only thing that matters. Your name, your brand, or whatever else they want to fucking call it. If you're a draw, if you're a ticket seller, if you can. No! It's about your rep. That's it. That's the only thing that ever matters is your rep. So you know what? Let's go build it. There's no reason not to.
There's no reason. The only constants, Dave McCall, Nate Carter. Keep watching.